OSP, Open Source Publishing. We are a design collective that currently consists in 7 people. Here you can see Pierre on the left, me, Femke, Yi, Harrison, and Eva. Yi is here in the public with you, and Nicolas, he left on the first picture, but he's part two on our collective. He works in Barcelona.
Thank you, Alexander, for the picture.
Yes, thank you. And there is Lauren too, the girl on the right, and she's a student in Belgium. Is it okay with the song?
No,
quite.
I think you have to, yes.
Here, now. So.
Just clip it on like that. Oh, yeah, that's
yeah. Is this okay? You hear me?
So, and Laurent, last arrived in the group, he is a student in Kent, in Belgium. So we are graphists, typographers, cartographers, developers, programmers, and activists, designers, writers. So we are closely affiliated with the Brussels-based Digital Culture Foundation, Constant. Actually, OSP is part of the association. So we are working mostly in Brussels, but we don't have a fixed studio. So we work on our apartments, on our flats. We work sometimes in a Constant studio
office.
We work when we travel. So this week we work together, and we live in a flat with a kitchen. So we eat together, we work together, and it's fine. So even in the flight from Brussels, we begin to work here with Pierre Marchand and Nicolas. And it begins with email exchange with with Louise, a woman. She's the woman who
she's an outdoor.
Yeah. So it was funny because we had to write an email to her each week from 3 months ago to have the reservation valid. So we exchange with her about weather in Belgium and here, and so we have a nice story about it.
She decided not to make pay for us for the reservation, only an email per week.
So OSP started in 2006 as a simple experiment. Now we are serious about testing the possibility and limitation of free and open source software, so in a professional design environment.
And maybe more as a background, last year, hello to everyone. As designer, we explored the hypothesis that to work only with free license and software, design software, will change our relation with the design, the relation between us, and also the relation to our commissioner. It worked. It changed really a lot of stuff, a lot of things. Maybe also the fact that we release all our design, all our work laptop, but not only the software, but the tool. It's a way to, well, that's good, to change things. Also, like last year in Poland, we, in a conference like this, where developers meet users, we are interested to question the apparent dichotomy, the separation between these two kind of humans. And a bit like Mr. Pittman said yesterday, we do not think there is so huge difference between the two. And we question the fact about developing a software is only to code it. We think that a software is also part of the culture, and so by using it and by actively questioning it, speaking about it, also of course modifying to smile, it's an important way of developing it in the full extent of the book. Yes, that's Jacques Rancière.
Do you want to translate?
Yes, maybe I just translate the first because we have to change that. Maybe I don't know how much of the people speak French here. So the first sentence says something like emancipation. I think that word exists in English. Begin when we question the opposition between look and act. I think it's clear enough. And maybe to ease that development, in parallel of design and doing real job in design, we collaborate to do workshops in several different ways and environment. Yes, that's okay, we can. That's in Bordeaux 2 months ago. There is an important conference on design about norms and formats with well-known people in the design field, but also Bruno Latour, by example, so more philosophic way of seeing design. And this conference is a 3-day conference. And at the top floor of the Musée d'Art Contemporain in Bordeaux, and we have a workshop with students in the ground floor, on the ground floor. So we work to build a relation, a physical relation to begin, by actively gluing tapes with our feet like that in the stairs between the two spaces. And physically also work on the apparent opposition or separation between students and professional experts. So these are the usual suspects. So we make kind of journalist work on them. And each of these 3 days we question that space, that separation. We can go, yes, so that's what inspires us. It's a crying room designed mostly in Texas in the 50s to separate wives with crying children in cinemas, and okay, so it's a bit, we see that as a brutal way of separating it, but it's also, you can see it something smooth, because so women with children can go to the cinema and also speak and maybe smoke, like in the 50s. It's all crying room to make emphasis between that non-separation which try to reach. We invite Pierre Marchand as a developer, of Thermatrix and Square Design, but also as an artist. And we have a student from design field, but also from sociology, marketing, journalism, and computer science. And yeah, it was full 3 days. We decided at the beginning to use only open source free license software. So the result, the immediate result was that we use no software at all, because most of the students do not have any free software, do not want to launch live CDs, and so.
Yeah, but there was the very nice experience of one design student who actually, can you hear me okay? Yeah, there was one design student who actually installed Ubuntu without actually knowing anything about the operating system before the workshop, so that's, I think that's a very good accomplishment, I would say.
Mm-hmm. And so we have movies, but with the switch of computer, I don't know, that because our Ubuntu computer.
Do I switch?
No. So we begin from macOS.
Which one?
Yes, the mirror to begin.
Just double click on it?
Yes, okay. And then something like. Yes, so we use Word as a screen to add progressively all the content, the gathering, the questions about the conferences. Because these conferences was streamed, so we are able to look at the conferences and to discuss. And we just missed the translation because most of the conferences were in English. So we translate by ourselves. So it was a non-neutral translation. And it was really a rich experience. That's at the end, and we invite all the people from the top. Yes, maybe I can close it, and that's an important moment. We must have sound, or it's not useful. During all presentation, as experts invited for the workshop, we show students in the ground floor working on the last part that they arrive in the space. And that was the moment where we finally found the way to do it. And that's another stuff, a radio show, because we like to change also the dimension where we work, so with the sound. And by cooking, of course, for those who know us, know that we use a lot of cooking as a way of cooperation between the two practices and a way of exchanging something physical also. Okay, the workshops, we begin to with the small.
So, do you want to? Liberty Nash?
Okay.
That one of all forms.
But we'll speak again about it after.
Yeah.
So, this is.
I don't know if we have still a picture of the platform, or you begin.
Yeah, this is a quote by Florian Kramer. He's a German media theorist. And this is a quote from a...
Do you hear something?
Do you hear something?
Just talk a little louder.
Okay. He lives in Rotterdam. He organized a conference called Film Pixel. It will happen next week, and we were talking with him. We really didn't like the title, and so this is some of the email exchange that we had. But I bring him up because he's the director of a school in Rotterdam, and one of the things that OSP has done in the past year was to design the catalog for an exhibition of that school, and it was designed with skills. We were very happy with the result that we got from skills. Pierre is passing it around. What I want to speak about is the cover of the book. The cover was made with the Python API. All the people who were exhibiting, I was one of them. Everyone contributed one image or one text even. And with the Python scripting, we were placing each of these contributions randomly on each one of the copies. So every copy was a bit different. This is some of the script. And I think that this is interesting because it's in a very simple way, it's showing how software can build a collaborative platform, because the cover was an entire was just a collaborative exercise. Hopefully you can look at it. One of the elements of the cover was a picture of Florian Kramer. It was blown up so that each book corresponded to one pixel. And what was sort of special about it was that you would only see a picture when the books were all together, and this only happened when the exhibition opened. So this is one image of it. Here you see some of the differences on the contributions. And another thing that I think it's important to mention is that we could not have finished the book without the help of the Skrivus support without the help of the main list and the IRC channel.
That's another book commissioned by the Media Art Institute for the Flemish part of Belgium, the BAM. They want us to make a book full of text about media art in Flanders, and at the same time they are finally released a long 3-year work on their website with a database full of data on artists and organizations in Flanders. And at the end we ask for a 16-page experiment where we try to compare the content of the book, so the dream of BAM dreaming of itself, and a certain kind of reality inside the database. So we begin really from scratch without any information about the database. We only have a dump to not overload the server, and we work on it with a designer of the BAM, Michael Moto, developer, computer scientist, and Nicolas, he and I are doing the layout and scripts. Maybe you can give the and so we begin to explore the database. After a certain moment, we finally ask for a flowchart on the design of the database. We received that one that was designed before to do the database 3 years ago. And by example, we discovered that there is no field about the sex in the database. We cannot know if there is a women artist or a man artist. So we tried to use a row system of counting the first name. And so we can see that in media art and other, the 10th first names are, no, the 8th first names are men's names, and the first female name is S. So maybe it's not because there is more men artists, but because the women first name are more different dispersed statistically, but you don't see it now. Yes, that's our extract of these days of working with Node. And these are a result of the, so we do queries in the database in SQL, then we have with small PHP script, we have a SVG file row that we modify with Inkscape. These are row output. Normally we have pictures of the pages, but we don't seem to appear. These are pictures in the page explaining the process. Thank you. And we use several ways of trying to analyze the database. We try to see which are the relations between people, organization, place. So place in Flanders, but also we found really little description on international network, but we found lots of stuff about international network in the CVs, so we try to make a map of it, but it's in the picture, obviously. because it's at the end of the book. It's in Flemish. We're working on translation in French and English.
Okay.
That's the content of a project we currently have, a map of publishing software history with several layers. We will work on it the few next days and ask to some of you a bit more information about.
Maybe we can speak a little bit.
Yes, I don't know, because we don't have the pictures. Okay, for some.
Another book?
Yeah, this is another book. It was also published in Rotterdam. It was it's a collection of essays, of critical essays about the possible intersections between free software and art.
For this book create a font, we modify a font. His picture. So we built Libertinage by copying and pasting part of the Linux Libertine GIF, or simply by turning GIFs. So there are 27 chapters in the books, and we built 27 variations of the font. So basically for the chapter one, that's we modify the A, for the chapter two B, and etc. etc. So
that's better.
You could have seen here the full one versions, so all the letters are modified. Is Flossa book here?
Yes.
Oh, okay. So you can see in the books. You have seen the topics of our conference was 1 year of work, so we explore it chronologically. So, and here are some pieces of them, so you can take them, you can have one. I will now speak about this map. It was a commission for the BPI in Paris, the Public Information Library. So it was for a festival, documentary film festival. Just go. And so the map shows the program, or it completes it, giving an alternative reading. The goal was to get out of a linear way to arrange theme and movement. So we worked together with the artistic director of the festival, Javier Paquer, to draw as territorial relations between the movies, inviting the viewer to go for a walk, to go for a drift between all the movies. So there is more than 100 movies, documentaries. For this work, we work in close relation with the artistic director. So this map is more done by its director than us, in a certain way. So if you look at it, you will probably meet us. These are the eyes of one of the character of La Jetée, a movie from by Chris Marker. So we start from this picture, and we work with Inkscape. We spent 2 weeks on Inkscape, and it was a pleasure. So we learned to manage paragraph style in the SVG. In the SVG code, we tried to, and it works. we are playing with the clone feature to distribute pictograms and modify them from one. So you modify one, and that helps a lot. We use the type on curves and. Okay, so we produce OSPD too for it. It allows us to freely overflow from the corporate identity of the center. About this Dean and whole Dean research, you can have a look to our website, because we work a lot about it. One of the other fonts we used, this version we drew is based on a 1932 grid.
The first version.
We used the OSP Atlas, world tour in 80,000 click font gathered by Harrison. And about the production, we import the Inkscape files as SVG, in Scribus, and converted colors into it CMGN manually. About the clone feature, we prefer separate the clone browsers over again at this moment, because we remarked that it sometimes reacted strangely, moving or grouping themselves. So PDFs looked good. Mm. It's always a bit frustrating to have to convert and the path and ungroup things so brutally. Not so brutally, but at this moment. Because you convert all, just hoping that there will be no correction after that, because you will have to. But it worked well. We did two Inkscape files, one black and white, and one for the CMYK, and we separated it. And the graphist who worked for the booklet in which the map was inserted just gathered them. So here we have some map printed, and we also made an installation in the center. That was a really nice experience. So we installed it with tape in the hall of the George Pompidou Center in Paris. So that was just as if we had gone through the screen, placing pictogram by hand on our knee. So we translating the file into an object, the vector into a movement. So it was a translating space. We draw a grid to like to help to place things. graffiti artist
Fix,
a friend of Harrison in Paris, helped us a lot drawing. Pretty curves with tape, so he had good techniques. or his face. It's we can see here the interpretation is what gives vibration to the installation, because we had to manage when the here is one view of the results. So you can take maps after the show. Who's next? We speak about some other small shops.
Yes.
We do too.
No, we don't have it. Yeah.
Okay.
That was finished work, kind of finished work, because they are on the freelance and never completely finished. But now we have a long-term job, accidentally long-term job. It was defined to take 3 months, but it's still not finished. I think it's around one work now, to do a complete book in tech. We are just 4 years in tech, so we finally decide to do a 300 pages complex multilingual book. And what to say? We start like everybody from zero with LaTeX, and then finally after a few months we decide that it's really too complex to modify deeply, so we switch to Context and another kind of distribution of tech, and we currently manage it far better. Still some problem with fonts, but we hope to show that on next year.
So yeah, these are unfinished works.
This is a gender artnet project. OSP take part in the development of this project. It's the that project they propose to create an interactive atlas which will give access to different view and different artistic position from a set of feminist artistic point of view in the contemporary Europe. So it's supported by the European Cultural Foundation, produced by the curator Bettina Knaup, and in collaboration with Constant, the association. The project team gather curator, artist, developer, statistician. It explores relations between genders, territories, artists, artwork, group, network, and events through different thematic and fields of discussion fields. The database of the project is fed with information from the editorial team. And information extracted from the artist's website. So we work to make visible the and interactive the different levels of information. We work in collaboration with a statistician, Anne Buisson, to we can see other view. So with Anlog, we try to distribute and specialize a significant keyword. I don't have here in relation with artists. The data from the editorial team place locate the artist place of origin and the artist place of residence, and connect artists with discussion fields with artworks, place network, and group of artists. So actually, Nicolas work on it, trying to implementate. We can do it. Trying to
implement
the graphic layout and so he's working on the interface of the project, and we will speak about it more and better the next time. So when it will be online and we will test it. So yeah, have you the layout?
Also with gender art, I think it's very interesting that Nicolas, who is not here, he's developing it, and he's a good example of, I don't know what to call him, if he's a user or a developer. So to me, those sort of categories are not very clear, and hopefully with something like gender art, they can sort of open up the discussion as to how these things could perhaps be more more flexible. I think that I'm also not very comfortable with calling or design professional work. I don't know if we're professional users. I think we're just users who think and reflect and try to be conscious of the software that we're using. And I also think that this is relevant in that, hopefully by showing you the type of work that we do with the software that that you built. We're using your software. Perhaps we can open up the discussion as to developing software in more idiosyncratic ways.
Okay.
And yeah, how?
I think we are quite finished. We have something to announce for this noon at around 12. I don't have the precise hour. Maybe you can talk a bit about it. Nicolas, a workshop there in front of a beautiful Montréal.
Bonjour à tous, hi everyone. So just a few words about what we plan to do over the lunch break. The idea is to provide an opportunity for us to explore the tools of font design, the Open Font Design Toolkit. We want to focus on four aspects, basically give you a chance to dive in a progressive way. So first, installing the toolkit itself, getting it on your machine or a virtual machine, seeing how we can tweak it, how we can configure it in a certain way, make it look slightly better theming and so on. Then we want to add a few extra glyphs, just simple exercises, then tweak some of the contact script settings, alternates and so on. And this is going to be done on a font that OSP and a couple of us with students did at the last LGM in Poland.
This one.
Yeah, so Verge was the name that we chose for that. These fonts on the way, on our way. So we will add a few letters to this font, and then we will go into preparing the font for a release on the Open Font Library, getting through the best practices of preparing the font sources, the extended sources, the description, the metadata, and so on, creating a specimen so that it can be seen before it's downloaded. Then we will publish it. We'll see how it actually works with uploading that. making it more widely known. And then we will do a quick demo of using that font in a website using the AdFont Face standard. So these are the goals. So we really invite you to dive in and come along. There will be Denny Jackery from the DevGV project and Dave Crossman also helping out. So please come along. Thank you.
Thank you.
So you are free to take
yes.
poster you want.
Posters.
And
maybe
here is another.
A few questions. I think we have some time. We take too much time.
Are there any questions?
Yes.
You talk a lot about like producing the catalog and working with the developer. I'm curious how you actually end up printing the work. How you print the work? Who do you work with? Because that's a big deal to go from your computer to an actual book.
You're absolutely right. It's a big deal. Last year in LGM, we talked a bit about the problem we had with the printer to output the crossover book, for example. Because most of the printers in Belgium use, of course, proprietary software as a workflow, and the perfectly standard PDF we output with Scribus are not so standard for them, are not enough Adobe standard. So we have sometimes problems. Yes, we try to go ahead of this problem by discussing with the printer, saying, okay, we do it like that. It won't be Adobe PDF, but we'll try to output that normally, there's no problem. And more deeply now, we are in contact with the printer, doing kind of strange and interesting flying print shop, using different print shop in the night. So he has not his own machines, but he rents print shop in the night. And we'll try to build a complete free workflow with him. It's only the start of it. We'll see.
And you want to add?
No, the thing is that we have to use different software to produce PDF ready to print, so we have to manage and have a recipe.
But we can finalize many of them in Scribus to put in the PDF. Maybe the tech one will be an exception. In that case, without exception.